Hey everyone, Lorenzo here from Omega Bond Watches. Welcome back. Today I'm going to finally get to this Tom Cruise pair of sunglasses that he wears in the trailer for Mission Impossible Dead Reckoning Part 1. A lot of people have said they thought it was going to be Randolph Engineering, specifically the Concords from their line. I'm here to tell you they're not. Other people have said it's the Tom Ford Marcos. No, it's not. And a couple people thought they were a pair of Ray-Bans. So after some detective work and spending some time looking, I found a pair. I ordered them. And in fact, it's actually a pair of Cartier. And I think this is kind of a strange choice for Ethan Hunt, all things considered. But this is definitely a huge jump in style for a spy. Just to give you kind of some of the facts here about these sunglasses, retail at Cartier, these are $995. Not anywhere in the realm of something I'm used to spending on sunglasses, but you can find them at some authorized dealers. This pair has been discontinued, so you can find them for about $500 to $600, $700, depending. There's a few pairs left that I've seen online. The model number is CT0038S, and the color code, which I find extremely interesting, is 007. So I don't know if that's a nod to Bond, a dig at Bond or whatnot, but I just thought it was kind of funny, the coincidence of that being the color code. And the actual color of the frames is ruthenium silver, which is in the platinum family. So what they do is they alloy ruthenium to platinum or any other kind of metal to create this hardened, shiny finish. And then the other color, because the sunglasses are actually a two-tone pair of sunglasses, Cartier calls it champagne golden metal. So take that as you want. To me, it's just gold. Champagne gold sounds kind of cool, but that's the colors. So you got ruthenium against gold champagne metal. So now let's talk about lenses. The lenses are a gray lens with a silver tone flash, which it's basically like it creates an iridescent like kind of look on the outside. So like you get this like mirror look, and then on the inside the lenses are actually a blue. It's almost like the Skyfall sunglasses, the Marcos. It's like a blue finish on the inside. So obviously, you know, I'll put some pictures up so you can kind of see these things. But a big signature of the Santos de Cartier, which is the official name of this sunglass, they like to put the screws, the Cartier screws, into the frame. So those are done in the champagne golden finish, and then most of the frame is just the ruthenium silver. But very luxurious pair of sunglasses. I've gotten a chance to wear them quite a bit. I would say this is not something I would get in the habit of doing. It's a little bit out of the range of what I feel comfortable spending on a pair of sunglasses, but I can honestly say for what I paid for them, they definitely hold up to their value. It's a very luxurious pair of sunglasses, very thin wireframe. In my opinion, I think they're better than the Marcos, just by a durability factor, like looking at them, wearing them, and being used to them. I've had my Marcos for 12 years. They've held up. They're great. But this to me is just a different level. And it's mainly because of the materials they're being used. I mean, sunglasses are sunglasses when it comes to design, but when you get into the material aspect of it, that's kind of what makes a huge difference in the wearability, the longevity, all those kinds of things. So I don't know. So let me pull these guys out. So it comes in this hard, Cartier case that's kind of like rounded. You open it up. There's a little Cartier sunglass bag it comes with, which I put them in there sometimes. It makes it a pain to kind of get them out, but I guess I'll put that there. And then here's the sunglasses. I don't know if you can see the blue lenses in there, but like I said, I'll post some pictures. But yeah, they come with a leather temple cover, and it has a screw in the middle of it. I took it off. I mean, if I'm going to wear these, I want them to look pretty much like they do on screen, because that's what grabbed my attention. But I love the fit. I think it's great. The lenses are 61 millimeters in width, and then the bridge is 16 millimeters, and then the temples are 135 millimeters. So very, it's a little bit on the larger side for sunglasses, but these ones fit my face really well. I really like the way they feel. I think the thing that was hard to get used to was how thin the arms on these are, but they're just one solid piece of metal. There's no leather or plastic finishings on these. It's basically all metal. The only thing not metal on here is obviously the lenses and the nose pads. But yeah, I mean, if you want to go to that level of like just extreme luxury, Cartier definitely is one of those brands. And well, like I said, one of their things is they don't like to make a ton of sunglasses. So there are a few of these floating around still that I've seen, but it's not going to be some, I know they've discontinued the model. They're not going to make it anymore, but who knows? Maybe they'll do a release around the movie. But yeah, so these are the sunglasses that Tom Cruise will be wearing in the new Mission Impossible film, which we should be getting next year, hopefully. But yeah, if you have any comments or questions, you know, hit the comment section below. Also, if you could, like and subscribe, and hopefully you'll like some of the other content I'll have coming out soon.